students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we will do part 3 of chapter Measurement. In this part, we will learn measurement of capacity. When we talk about measurement, we do measurement of length, measurement of weight or mass, and measurement of capacity. Students, in previous two parts, we learned measurement of length. Now today, in this part 3, we will learn measurement of capacity. Students, let's see the units to measure capacity. First unit is milliliter, which is denoted by ml. Milliliter is used to measure small quantity of liquids like coffee in a cup, lemonade in a glass, medicine in eyedropper, they are all measured in milliliter. Second unit to measure capacity is liter. It is denoted by L. Liter is used to measure large quantity of liquid. For example, milk pouch, juice bottle, water in bathtub are all measured in liter. And the third unit to measure capacity is kiloliter, which is denoted by KL. Kiloliter is used to measure very large quantity of liquid. For example, water in a tanker, water in a swimming pool, they are measured in kiloliter. So students, to summarize, milliliter is used to measure small quantity of liquids, liter is used to measure large quantity of liquids, and kiloliter is used to measure very large quantity of liquids. Now let's see conversion of capacity units. First, let's see how to convert liter into milliliter. 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter. So to convert liter into milliliter, multiply by 1000. On the basis of this relationship, few more relationships can be established between liter and milliliter. First is half liter equals to 500 milliliter. To understand this, students, take a look at this 1 liter mug. If we fill half of this 1 liter mug with water, then we can say it will contain half liter of water or 500 milliliter of water. Similarly, 1 by 4 liter or a quarter liter is equals to 250 milliliter. In the same way, 3 by 4 liter or 3 quarters liter is equal to 750 milliliter. Students, now let's do some exercise. Question is, how many times will you use following container to fill a jug of capacity 1 liter? Capacity of this given container is 100 milliliter. So students, how many times will we use this 100 milliliter container to fill a 1 liter jug? Yes, 10 times, because we know 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter, and 1000 divided by 100 is 10. Therefore, we will use this container 10 times to fill a jug of capacity 1 liter. Now, capacity of this second container is 250 milliliter. So, how many times will we use this 250 milliliter container to fill a jug of 1 liter? Yes, 4 times, because again 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter, and 1000 divided by 250 is 4. So we will use this container 4 times to fill a jug of 1 liter. Now, next container has capacity of 500 milliliter. So again, we will divide 1000 by 500 and answer comes out to be 2. So we will use this container 2 times to fill a jug of capacity 1 liter. The last container has capacity of 200 milliliter. So students, what will be the answer? Yes, it is 5 times. Again, we will divide 1000 by 200 and answer comes out to be 5. So we will use this container 5 times to fill a jug of 1 liter. Second question is, milkman has the measuring cups of capacity 100 milliliter, 200 milliliter and 500 milliliter. Use these cups to measure the following. First is 700 milliliter of milk. Students, to measure 700 milliliter of milk, which cup will we take first? Yes, 500 milliliter. Now, 700 minus 500 is 200. So let's take second cup as 200 milliliter. So students, to measure 700 milliliter of milk, the milkman will use cups of 500 milliliter and 200 milliliter. Now, next is milkman has to measure 300 ml of milk. So, which cup will he take first? Let's take 200 ml of cup. 300 minus 200 is 100. So, let's take second cup as 100 ml. So, students, to measure 300 milliliter of milk, this milkman will use cups of 200 ml and 100 ml. In the third scenario, the milkman has to measure 800 ml of milk. So first he takes 500 ml of cup. Now 800 minus 500 is 300. So to measure 300 milliliter of milk, this milkman will first use 200 milliliter cup and then 100 milliliter cup. So students, to measure 800 ml of milk, this milkman uses all these three cups. Now let's do some questions based on conversion of liter into milliliter. Question is, convert 15 liters into milliliter. Students, we know 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter. Therefore, 15 liters equals to 15 into 1000, which is equals to 15,000 milliliter. Second question is, convert 2 liter 970 milliliter into milliliter. Students, 2 liter 970 milliliter means 2 liter plus 970 milliliter. 970 is already in milliliters. So let's convert 2 liter into milliliter. We know 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter. So 2 liters equals to 2 into 1000 milliliter, which is equals to 2000 milliliter plus 970 milliliter. So answer comes out to be 2970 milliliter. Next question is, convert 71 by 2 liter into milliliter. Students, 71 by 2 liter means 7 liter plus 1 by 2 liter. We know 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter. So 7 liter equals to 7 into 1000 milliliter. And we just learned half liter equals to 500 milliliter. So we get 7000 milliliter plus 500 milliliter, which is equals to 7500 milliliter. Next question is, convert 5 3 by 4 liter into milliliter. 5 3 by 4 liter means 5 liter plus 3 by 4 liter. Let's convert 5 liter into milliliter by multiplying with 1000. And we just learned 3 by 4 liter is 750 milliliter. So students, we get 5000 plus 750 milliliter, which is equals to 5750 milliliter. Now, let's do conversion of milliliter into liters. Students, 1000 milliliter equals to 1 liter. So, to convert milliliter into liter, divide by 1000. To convert milliliter into liter, it is very important that you know how to divide by 1000 without using long division method. So students, I suggest that you watch my video of part 3 of chapter division. Let's start with the questions. Convert 4500 milliliter into liter and milliliter. Students, we just learned that to convert milliliter into liter, we will divide by 1000. So let's divide 4500 by 1000. We learned in chapter division that on division by 1000, the digits at ones, tens and hundreds place become remainder and remaining digits become question. So here 500 is the remainder and 4 is the question. And this question becomes the liter and remainder portion becomes the milliliter. So answer is 4 liter 500 milliliter. Next question is, convert 9175 milliliter into liter and milliliter. Students, to convert milliliter into liter, let's divide by 1000. And as we did in the previous question, on division by 1000, the digits at ones, tens and hundreds place become remainder and remaining digits become question. So here 175 is the remainder and 9 is the question. So our answer is 9 liter 175 milliliter. Next question is, convert 70,000 25 milliliter into liter and milliliter. Students, let's divide by 1000. And on division by 1000, 25 becomes the remainder and 70 becomes the question. So our answer is 70 liter 25 milliliter. Now students, let's see the relationship between kiloliter and liter. Let's first see how to convert kiloliter into liter. 1 kiloliter is equals to 1000 liters. So students, to convert kiloliter into liter, multiply by 1000. Now let's see how to convert liter into kiloliter. 1000 liter is equals to 1 kiloliter. So to convert liter into kiloliter, divide by 1000. So students, in this video, we learned units to measure capacity and their conversion. This is the summary for the conversion of units to measure capacity. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then do hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Learning Notebook and make sure to press the bell icon. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.